Welcome to the first edition of Magoos Corner. I'm your host Trevor Gregg, and I'm happily joined by Damien Leonard, or also known as the Fist, from Portland. Welcome, Damo.
Thanks, Trev. Cheers for having me.
Now, this is the first time that any reserves football has been covered by any media, so this is a really good opportunity to get your name out there, and of course to get some recognition for your efforts on a Saturday. Now, what we'll do is we'll start off with previewing the round one of the Division 1 reserves. So this week we have Ross Trevor Old Collegians versus Adelaide Uni out at Rocks, which will be quite an interesting game.
Yeah, past experience last year seeing Ross Trevor a pretty good side in both A's and B's, so I think it's going to be a good game, but Ross Trevor should probably get over the top in this one, I would have thought.
Yeah, definitely agree with, especially with the inclusions the Rocks have had in their A grade. It'll definitely filter through and they'll be a very strong force this year. Also, we've got Goodwood Saints versus Teatra Gully. This will be another reason of why Goodwood are so strong in this division. They've had some inclusions again, and also I think they're just going to be too good for Teatra Gully, aren't they?
Yeah, last year's premiers, I believe. So the only thing working for Teatra Gully is obviously it's a fair old trip out to Teatra Gully for Goody Saints. They probably don't like heading out into the northern suburbs either, but. Yeah, Goody Saints are a class act in both A's and B's as well, so yeah, they're the two sides to really beat in Divi 1 and Divi 1 reserves, I'd say, is Goody Saints and Ross Trevor. Yeah. So
absolutely. Also, we've got Port Districts versus the new kids on the block in Paynanoa Union down at Largs Reserve. Especially as what we've been talking about in the A grade series, there's going to be a lot of inclusions with Clates bringing friends down, and I do think that they will be far too strong for Paynham, although we did meet them in a trial earlier this year.
Yeah, I didn't get to see the old Paynham-Portland trial. I was away having a few tins, but yeah, Paynham, I'm sure they pride themselves on, so I know a few lads that play in their lower grades and they're backing themselves in at being a chance, so at Port Districts, anything can happen, but I'm hoping that Paynham get up over Districts, so I'm not a big fan of them boys, but yeah.
Well, I knew you'd say it, absolutely, you know, so I wanted to be neutral. Obviously, but another club that has been extremely demanding of their team, with Gary McIntosh through the A grade, B's, and of course with the 18s, they've recruited heavily. I think Tommy and the boys cleared that up before, so I think there's going to be a lot of the top three to four sides are going to be the ones that have recruited extremely well. And we've got
Sacred Heart versus Henley at Sacred Heart, so. Battle of the Pretty Boys, basically, is what I would consider it. So, Sacred Heart coming up from Divi 2, Henley, a very strong side. Smaller oval may suit Sacred Heart and not allow Henley to get all the run that they like. But for me, it's hard to go past Henley in most grades. So, yeah, Henley for me on that one. Yeah,
Henley for me also. And last of all, we've got Salisbury North versus our lads. Out at Salisbury North. So this will be a test for Salisbury North. As we heard before, there's not been much movement in regards to recruiting for Salisbury North. Whether they're keeping that quiet or not, I don't know. But the same with us, we just keep soldiering on. And I'm definitely going to say that we are hopefully going to have our first win on the weekend.
Yeah, I think you can't go past obviously your home club and playing in the twos. So I'm just going to back our boys in to start the season off a bit better than we did last year and yeah, build on what we finished off the 2014 season with, so a few close ones, and hopefully, yeah, we can start again, as you're probably going to hope as well. So
yeah, it depends on
the coach. A bit biased on that one, being both from Portland and whatnot, but yeah, Salisbury North, at Salisbury North always is a tough ask for any team, so yeah.
I think from memory, that the round, I can't remember what round it was, but when we played out there, and our second on the return run,
yep.
They came out and scored very heavily against us. We had no answers. I think it was mainly because our full back was too busy trying to be up at centre half forward. I think it was completely yelling and screaming.
We don't have to worry about that bloke anymore. He's out at the Chicks now. So
he's now Kilburn's problem. So we'll leave that with you, and we thank you for your time. We look forward to catching up with you next week with the results of round one.